to talk about that, amen, praise God, and learn some good things tonight about what's going on in these last days and what we can watch out for, what we can look for, amen, so we don't be caught, what, off guard, amen? Hallelujah, glory to God. So I hope y'all been doing your research. Y'all been doing your research? Amen, praise God. Y'all been reading up on what we've been talking about the last couple weeks? Amen? Hallelujah, glory to God. You want to do your own search in the Bible, amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. You always want to search the scriptures, what the preacher is talking about. Whether it's me or whoever it is, amen?
Amen.
You always want to go back over and make sure that what he is saying is lining up with the Word of God.
Amen.
Because I'm going to tell you something. There's a foundation being built, and there's only two types. There's a foundation of sand and a foundation that's based on the rock. Amen?
Yeah.
The Bible gives a depiction of a man that's building a house, a wise man and a foolish man. Okay, the foolish man is building his house on sand. It looks good up top, but the foundation is too shifty. So when the storms come, amen, praise God, and it rains on him, his beautiful house that he took so much time to build, but didn't take any attention to give it the right foundation, is all destroyed in a matter of one storm takes the whole house out. One storm, one trial takes the whole house out. And we know that the race is not given to the swift, nor to the strong. Amen, praise God. But the Bible says that he that endureth unto the end, come on somebody, y'all got to help me. Amen, praise God. The same is going to be saved, right? So in order to build a house, our temple, glory to God, in order to have a temple that's solid, amen, that's going to endure unto the end, that means we have to take special consideration of the foundation that we build our house on.
Amen.
Hallelujah, glory to God. It's very important because if the foundation is shifty and shaky, no matter how good and grand your house is going to be, one storm is going to take it out. Hallelujah, glory to God. I'm reminded of a story. It's a very simple story, but it has a whole lot of truth to it. Amen. Y'all remember the story of the three little pigs?
Yeah.
Y'all remember that story of the three little pigs? Amen, praise God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. One had a house of straw, one had a house of sticks, and one had a house of bricks. Remember that? Amen. And the wolf came to the house. The other little two pigs, they really wasn't taking notes on the house that they was built. And the wolf came, he said, I'm going to huff it, I'm going to puff, I'm going to blow your house down. Amen. He outside woofing. Woofing. Amen. Praise God. Hey, come on, son. He's woofing at the house. Amen. The little pigs out there were secure. The little pigs out there were secure. Amen. Praise God. I was watching the Muppets. Amen. Praise God. And as the wolf blew down the first house, the straw, amen, he said, ha ha, pigs in the blanket. Amen. Amen. So he went to the next house of sticks, was a little sturdier, but it wasn't solid. And he says, little pig, let me in. Amen. And then the pig said, I'm not going to let you in by the hair of my chinny chin chin. Then the big wolf said, I'm a huff, and I'm a puff, I'm going to blow your house down. Amen. Praise God. And he blew that house down too. Amen. Why? Because it wasn't built on a solid foundation. It wasn't a solid house. Amen. And the Bible says that the devil is walking about like a roaring lion seeking who he may devour. Hallelujah. And he depicts the lion as a raven wolves. Amen. On the outside, these people, they're dressed like sheep in sheep clothing, but on the inside, they're ravenous wolves, ready to devour you. Amen. Praise God. Ready to come in and take over your house. Ready to blow your house down. Ready to mess up your temple. Ready to mess up your temple. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
They come to mess up your temple. The temple. We are the temple of God. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. The Bible says we are the temple of the Holy Ghost. And if any man destroy this temple, God is going to destroy him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. So if Satan, one of his tactics is, if I can't beat him, I'm going to join him. If I can't beat him, I'ma join him. If I can't take him out, amen, praise God, being and doing what I do, coming to kill, stealing, to destroy, let me camouflage myself like a sheep. And let me ease in on the crowd. Oh, y'all got to catch that, amen, praise God. Let me ease in on the path of protection. Amen, praise God. Let me start sounding like them and shouting like them. And oh, y'all got to catch that, amen, praise God. Let me stop having my hands like them. Let me stop showing up on time for church like them. Let me stop putting them up and putting them down like them. Oh, hallelujah, glory to his holy name. Amen. So they won't detect what I'm trying to do. They won't detect, praise God, what's going on. Amen, praise God. They won't detect what's happening. Amen, praise God. And then when they least expect it, I'm going to pull my fangs out. I'm going to huff and puff and blow their house down. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. Amen, because I see that their house is not solid. Amen, a lot of shouting is going on, but the power is gone. Got a lot of Samsons in the church. Amen, they shaking themselves, but not knowing that their power is gone, that the spirit has left them. Amen, a lot of people Ichabod in the church. Amen, praise God. They got the apparatus. They got all the mechanics. Amen. Amen, praise God. They got all the mechanics. Amen, but the spirit is gone. They got an outward appearance, a godliness, an outward appearance of godliness, but they don't have the power on the inside them to keep them from doing the things that God disapproves of. Hallelujah. See, because we can't do this on our own. We need the Holy Ghost to come in and to shake ourselves loose from the things that are pulling us away from the presence of God. Amen. Amen. Give God's hand, praise. Amen. Hallelujah.